Actually, animal stories started when I was first doing the morning show. Only at that time it wasn't called Animal Stories. At that time, we had some dippy farm program on at 5:30 in the morning. So I started going through farm magazines and finding these bizarre stories about farm animals killing the farmers and things like that. And doing this and logging it as public service, a 5-minute farm show with all the sex and violence that I could get into it.
I wouldn't have it any other way. Right, little Tommy?
Right, Uncle Lair.
Good morning, chillins. It's time for Animal Stories.
I guess we can say that LS has its best success when the people on the air are allowed to be freest, something I think management should remember.
So that's 25 years of rock and roll with WLS. Now, chances of me being here for the 50th anniversary are slim and none, leaning heavily toward none, but I hope you will be. Some of the music of the 70s may have been lame, but the contests and the prizes weren't. WLS gave away records, cash, vacations, even a house. The giveaways were supposed to keep WLS listeners from jumping to arch-rival WCFL, but that didn't stop some people.
The man with no name listens to the world-famous Tom Murphy every morning on Super CFL. You listen to Tom Murphy because he's my friend.
So Sarat and Lujack became LS and CFL there for a while, and it was hyped up in the press, and the ratings were reported with great regularity, and we became the symbols for our stations there.
WLS in Chicago.
WLS, the first 25 years of the Rock of Chicago. It's our birthday special that opened the celebration, and we'll play it again Sunday night from 8 until 9.
I'll already be out of town. Is it any good?
I haven't heard it myself.
Well, I did it.
Oh. I guess I won't stay over then, huh?
It's spectacular.
Is it? Because would somebody like to explain why, I realize you may not have the fine tuning on your picture right now. Why are we on videotape? There's a guy in here with a camera. What is this all about?
Why don't we ask him? Art, why are you doing this?
For posterity.
Yeah.
Larry,
about,
I'm impressed already.
About your grandchildren.
You didn't have to bring your film crew in, Larry. I was impressed already.
We're reminiscing this morning. 591-8900, if you would like to call up and remind us about what went on back then.
Because we don't know.
We forgot.
Century 21.
Call a Greater Chicagoland Area Century 21 office today to find out more about their open house weekend. They're opening doors all over town. It's a great time to find a home you can afford. Each office independently owned and operated. 28 minutes before 10. Hi.
Hi, Larry.
Hey.
My name's James Dubo. I used to live in Lombard when Charlie Van Dyke was in.
Where do you live now?
In Springfield.
Oh, okay.
Did you live in Lombard, too?
No.
Oh.
Larry used to live in Lombard, too.
Yeah, city of lilac-colored garbage truck. Stimulating dialogue, and I wish we had time to continue, but we don't. It's 9:33.
WLS.
WLS. On the phone. Your name, sir?
My name is G. Michael.
Oh, I was hoping you were going to call this weekend, man. How you doing?
Well, first of all, I'm doing fine, thank you.
First, we should tell who this individual is. This is a former member of the WLS sales staff.
And promotion director.
WLS promotion director. And what are you doing? You're dealing drugs to the high school kids now, and what
and
are
proud
you?
As a peacock.
He's now the general manager of Q101 here in Chicago.
Well, we know what he listens to then, don't we?
Yeah.
Hi, G.
How you doing?
Excellent.
Welcome back. First of all, what unbelievable amount of money did they pay Larry to come in today and not go play golf?
All I know is there's an armed guard by his side.
It is gorgeous out there.
Well, hey, I'm done in 20 minutes.
Yeah.
Want to play? Got your checkbook with you?
Our foursome is full, thank you.
Oh.
But I wanted to know, in this solemn, this happy occasion of of 25th anniversary at WLS, and especially the period that Charlie was there, was sort of, to me, in my own mind, with all those memories, is sort of overshadowed by the general management of the radio station.
We touched on this just a few minutes ago.
I'm sorry I missed it, because...
But we just, as I said, we just touched on it, because this is... G. Michael was the promotion director, and I was program director in 73.
Yeah.
Charlie was doing mornings.
Yeah.
And I guess all of us had to run interference for everybody else at one time or another, but Mike Donovan can probably tell you more general manager stories than anybody.
The man in question is I don't think, any longer in the business. The last I heard from him, he is I got a mysterious call. And
yeah, he told me about this.
He is living with a woman of means in Miami.
Uh-huh. Does he pay her a lot for that, or what?
Well, LS was such a, you know, a tremendous radio station, is such a tremendous radio station. I remember particularly in June of 1973, it was prom night, and Ramsey Lewis was playing at the London House, which was just beneath the studio.
Burger King.
Right. And the general manager offered me a ride home.
In the Javelin?
In the Javelin that had a 425-inch blown engine on it. And as he stood, and he was not a good driver, and he also did not drink. But he'd had two black Russians, and as we got into the car, he started it up. And
executive house, right?
The executive house garage that is a long tunnel affair that shoots out past the sidewalks. As he gets into the car and sits down, for some reason, the accelerator stuck. And we blew out, missing narrowly, dozens of tuxedoed and pumped dressed ladies as they walked by, and we slammed into the center island where the oil pan broke.
Where the memorial oil slick remains to this day.
Paul R. Abrams memorial oil slick walked by, and my fondest memory is him lighting his fifth cigarette in a 10-minute period,
with
looking
ashes
up to see J.J. Jeffrey walking from the executive house and Paul hiding underneath the car so J.J. wouldn't see him.
Dark suit.
That's right, my son.
And you know, snapping his fingers.
This guy, this individual that we're talking about, we should have invited him back
to
this reunion. He is the most colorful, most interesting individual who has ever worked at this radio station.
Did you ever fully understand anything he ever said to you?
No, but he is the reason that I left.
Yeah, uh-huh. It did not become any clearer at 3 o'clock in the morning either, I'd like to remind all of us.
Coming up at 10 o'clock, J.J. Jeffrey with Fred Winston this afternoon, Bob Surratt, John Landecker. And then tomorrow from 1 to 5, I'm going to host with Chuck Knapp. And I was thinking, I touched on this earlier, Mike, that we're going to talk about the ledge.
Oh, my goodness.
And we're going to talk about the coffee cup.
Oh.
Remember the coffee cup?
Absolutely. Apple wouldn't be drinking coffee there. All day, and good to have you back, Charlie. And
nice to
happy
talk
birthday
to you.
To WLS.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Hey, Michael, what's your best score so far this year? And be honest.
87.
Dubs Dread?
No.
Oh, Wimp Course? No,
Wimp Course.
Wimp Course.
Wimp Course.
You played Dubs Dread yet?
Not yet. Haven't been down there.
Oh. Okay.
I'll give you a call.
You know my number.
You're
making
it.
All that money over there. You know?
I know, and I want some of it. I'm going to get it. Thanks for calling, guy.
Okay.
Okay, bye.
Thanks, Michael.
Bye. 943. WLS. Ramblin' Man, Allman Brothers Band, WLS, 10 before 10 o'clock. Radar weather, mostly cloudy this morning, becoming partly sunny and windy this afternoon with a high of about 77. Tomorrow, even warmer, more sunshine, Sunday's high in the low 80s. Also a 30% chance of thunderstorms toward evening tomorrow. Has anybody seen J.J. walk in yet?
No. I think Fred's here.
You think? Did anybody ask him about his furniture last night?
J.J., the inflatable furniture? That did not come up. No. Whenever he left town, there was just this giant... There's Jay! Walking in now. Come in here. Come on. We'll let him in.
Tell him to come in.
Considering that we've never met before and probably will never see each other again, we've done a great job of reminiscing.
Now that you're a multimillionaire, have you got some nice furniture?
Just unplug yet? And just unplug that mic that or the cans that are there in the hole there, JJ.
Oh, unplug these. Yeah,
just unplug that.
Okay.
There you go. Collaboration.
Okay. Very good. Go ahead, Liar.
I was asking, now that you're a multimillionaire, do you have some decent furniture yet, or is it still that blow up stuff, or did you have blow-up stuff or beanbag?
I had both. I had beanbag and the blow-up stuff. But it's vinyl, and vinyl, as we all know, is very durable.
Well, listen, I got to go. I got
to
go.
You have to go?
FM.
Oh, you're on FM. FM. I noticed the way you said FM.
Yeah, static free.
You loaded your voice. Yes.
Well, for those of you who
now,
enjoy...
How about an animal story before we go? I mean, we come thousands of miles here and...
Buy one of the albums, you cheap. Here, we have three of them out. I'll get you a discount.
Okay, great. Wonderful.
Now, for those of you who enjoy a little static with your music and conversation, JJ will be segueing over to Studio E, where Fred Winston awaits his arrival. And Tommy will...
Studio F.
I forget, though. I'm not simulcasting this morning, am I?
No.
I'm only on AM, so we don't care about you FM people today.
Okay.
But
Monday morning, they're vital.
Well, I'm going to jump in as soon as I get off, because I want to sit in briefly with JJ and Fred and then Bob and John Leindecker.
Oh, yeah.
That should be fun.
And I remember walking up to Tommy one day and saying, Tommy, I want to ride the bus, but I don't know how to ride.
That's right. That's right. You don't know how to put the money in the thing. Yeah.
And I didn't want to get yelled at by the bus driver. See? Yes.
True story.
And, Tommy said, you get in there, and there's this big round mound in the near the driver's section, and you put in your quarter, and you go and find
a seat.
All there is
you quietly go to the back, and you find a seat.
And I was talking to OC, one of the stellar engineers here last night, and he was talking about the Happy Bus.
Oh, the Happy Bus, yeah.
Yes. It was bus 151 or 153 here in Chicago.
This is the guy that when you get on the bus, he's, welcome to the Happy Bus. All God's children love the Happy Bus.
And it was wonderful. And I never got that guy.
Yes. Bye. Okay.
See my old buddy, Abe, and one of the great engineers he worked with.
Remind him that he still sucks.
This is that fantastic stuff. Who we got here?
I'm Larry's sidekick.
Les Grobstein, you do the sports?
That's right.
A WLS.
Right.
The enormous but not too gaudy, 89. What'd you think of the reunion?
It's not over yet.
Contain yourself. You think you're on the...
There's about 90 guys I've never met before. I don't...
Well, you'll meet them. Go upstairs and say hi to them. Introduce
Here's
yourself.
A guy that's worked with and against all these guys.
I'm just saying hi to...
Kick these guys back in the ratings.
This is great, Art. Good to see you again.
Larry.
I supplement my income by selling newspapers. You want to buy some?
Larry,
you've got the late trip.
What do you want, Art?
No, I just wanted to know what you thought of being a part of the reunion this year.
Stop. Leave me alone. I wish you people in the media would just leave me alone.
Really?
I thought it was...
I wish you'd leave me alone, too.
Yeah, leave us alone, Art. Goodbye.
Larry, it's been a slice. Thank you.
That was not coffee he was drinking. That was Sanka, so he has not lost his bet.
I'm Karen Hand, WLS News.
More of the Big 89 Rewind. With Larry Lujack and Tommy Edwards.
Music Radio WLS Chicago.
Tommy Edwards, Larry Lujack here in the morning. And we're back in the saddle again. Oh, we've got Dress to the Nation coming up. We have Celebrity Worship and something very special for those schools out there who can't afford a celebrity commencement speaker.
Yeah.
We're going to provide a commencement address to America's youth. And, if you're one of these cheap schools, you could record it. Why not? Huh?
Sure.
And,
sure. Good idea, Tommy.
We'd like to inspire the kids.
Good thinking. Mm-hmm. Where's the cough button here? I think I have to cough.
Oh, jeez. Here we go. Oh, wait a minute. I should hit my
All head. Right. yeah.
That'll be at 11:45.
Yeah. It's one of the stories we have today is about Ashton Kutcher's dogs. And believe me, Tommy... After you hear this, any respect that you ever had for Ashton Kutcher would be gone within 60 seconds after you hear it. You will be shocked and outraged.
Oh, my gosh. Hey, what we have to give away today is some of those very attractive Clark Weber books.
Who the hell does Clark Weber think he is? I've read some parts of this book, Tommy, and I was shocked and outraged.
Oh, jeez. All right, it's 9:16, and we'll be right back.
What I was going to ask, and it's like way back, but do you ever come back to town?
Seldom.
Seldom?
Mm-hmm.
Do you ever drive through Morris?
We're not welcome in Morris anymore.
I was wondering if you were not welcome in Morris, because it seemed like when I was a kid, every day you had something disparaging to say about the Morris Police Department and their handling of animals.
That's right. And then we went down and just whomped him in basketball. You remember that?
Played the Morris Police Department in a charity basketball game and just creamed him, Tommy. Just wiped him out.
Embarrassed him, yeah.
And so we were making fun of him on the air about that. Yeah, so that's why we try to stay out of Morris.
Aren't you going to talk up to the vocal? I guess not. WLS, Big 89, Rewind.
Christina Ricci. Here's a quote from her about what she carries in the glove compartment of her car, Tommy.
Yeah.
Christina says, quote, "I always carry a fresh change of underwear in my car. I like to be ready for anything." Celebrity worship is presented whenever we feel like it. For those of you who like to start your day in a spiritual way, follow us on the path of spiritual enlightenment, because we know the way and you don't. Here on the Big 89 Rewind on WLS.
Larry Lujack, Tommy Edwards, WLS.
Students, we have a couple of tips of jobs that you just want to avoid at all costs as you enter the next chapter of your life. First of all, don't go into the radio business. It's a dead end. It's a dead end job. No,
nobody knows that better than we do.
That's right. Big monolith companies run by Wall Street, people who don't know anything about broadcasting. They cut costs, they fire talent, build stations with signals so weak that some people just a few hundred yards away can't even hear it. Boy, we've been through that.
Oh, yeah. But I'd like to offer some words of hope and inspiration to you young graduates out there. But on average, of course, there are exceptions, but on average, each generation has done better than their parents in the history of this country. This is the first generation that will not do as well. So my advice to you young American graduates, when you make some money, hang on to it, because you're going to need it. Don't get caught up in the culture of consumerism in this country. The smart and strong will adapt and survive, Tommy. The weak and stupid will perish. In summary, for you graduating seniors, there is no cause for hope, but only despair. So lots of luck. You graduates, get out there and kick some ass.
This has been our inspirational commencement address to America's youth.
Larry Lujack.
I want to congratulate you again on induction into that National Association of Broadcasters Hall of Fame thing. We did that in April in Las Vegas, one of your least favorite cities.
Yeah.
And I'll have details on that in just a moment. God, it's dry here in the desert, ain't it?
Yeah, for sure. Well, thank you, Tommy. That's very nice.